today we are making the perfect steak served with not one, but two garlic sauces and my famous triple cooked chips. As a home cook, you might be wondering, how do I make the perfect steak? And I have done a lot of practice and a lot of research so you can make the perfect steak at home, just like I'm gonna show you today. And look, there are a few rules that you have to follow. These aren't guidelines, these are strict, hard-bound steak cooking rules. But once you get the hang of it, it's actually really simple to make at home, and it will definitely beat those steakhouse or fancy restaurant steaks. Now, the first rule of cooking steak is that it has to be room temperature. So I like to take it out of the fridge at least an hour before I'm cooking it, because if it's cold and it hits the pan, it's not gonna cook evenly throughout, and those juices aren't gonna be absorbed evenly throughout the steak, and it's just gonna be a little bit of a disaster. Not a full disaster, that's probably me being a little dramatic, but it is important that it is at room temperature. So I'm just gonna pat it dry with absorbent paper because we don't want a lot of moisture on our steak. And you'll see that I am using Scotch fillets today. That is my ultimate favorite cut of steak, which I think in America you call them ribeye, which can have a bone in it sometimes, but these are boneless Scotch fillets. They've just got this beautiful fatty marbling throughout them. They're a beautiful cut of meat and they are my number one pick, so I always cook with these. And then rule number two is we want to heavily season it with salt and pepper. And that pepper is going to create a beautiful crust on the steak when it hits the pan. And that crust is what makes your steak just so special. So go very heavy-handed on the pepper and salt, a little lighter on the pepper. So we're gonna do that on both sides. And then if any seasoning's fallen on the board or the plate, just give it a bit of a roll. And I'm just gonna set this to the side, and while I prepare the sauces, this is gonna have that salt absorb through it, and it's gonna be beautiful when we cook it. We're gonna get started on the first garlic sauce, which is the garlic butter sauce for the steak. So we need two whole bulbs of garlic that I'm gonna slow roast in the oven with a little bit of olive oil, salt, and pepper, just until those cloves are nicely caramelized and soft and we can squeeze them out. So we're just gonna cut the tip off. You just wanna do it deep enough until those cloves are fully exposed. Pop them in an oven-proof dish. A little salt, a little pepper, and then a good drizzle of olive oil. And it is important that when we're roasting these, that the lid has to be on, or you can do it in a sheet of alfoil if you like. They just need to be covered or they're gonna burn a little bit. So we'll pop that lid on, and then these are gonna roast in the oven for an hour at 200 degrees Celsius. The first sauce we're making for the steak is a garlic butter sauce. It's a compound butter, which means it's a flavored butter with lots of garlic, fresh parsley, lemon zest, and lots of butter. For that first steak sauce, which is the garlic herb butter, we've got our roasted garlic, which I'm just letting cool a little bit, just till it's easy to handle and we can squeeze out those caramelized cloves. And then we need a fair bit of parsley, about, I'd say, a large handful. And I am gonna put this in the food processor, but I'm just gonna roughly chop it because I want my butter to go nice and green and I want this to mix really well throughout it. So just a little rough chop. I'm gonna put that in my food processor. And then something I think I forgot to mention is that this also needs a little bit of lemon zest, just for that zesty, citrusy flavor that will work perfectly with your steak. Just a little lemon zest, probably from half a lemon. And then I have a stick of butter here, which in Australia is 250 grams, but we're gonna use about half of that. And we just wanna make sure that it's at room temperature, just so it easily mixes through in the processor and all those flavors work into it. You definitely don't need all of this butter for one steak, but it's always nice to make a little bit of a larger batch because that way you can store it in the fridge and just use it on anything that you cook with, from vegetables to a garlic bread if you like, some toast, some other steak or chicken it would work beautifully with. And now a little salt and pepper. I've got these juices in the bottom of the baking pot from what the garlic roasted in, so I'm just gonna add that because that is beautiful and delicious and we don't want it to go to waste. And then the garlic goes in, so just give it a big squeeze. And now I'm just gonna blend that on high until everything is well combined. That butter has been whipped to perfection. You'll see that all of those flavor elements are beautifully combined and it makes this delicious green, herby, garlicky and zesty butter that is perfect to top onto our steak. So I'm just gonna scoop it out. And I'm just gonna pop that in the fridge just so it slightly hardens. Now for that second garlic sauce that I'm gonna serve with my steak is a garlic, chili, and caper olive oil sauce. This is actually my mum's old recipe that she would make for us every time we ate steak at home. We would even drizzle it on vegetables or chicken. It's such a versatile, delicious sauce, but my favorite way to serve it, and hers too, is spooned over some beautifully cooked medium rare steak. So we need a lot of garlic, about I'd say 6 to 8 large cloves. And I'm just gonna peel those and then mince them through a garlic crusher. So I'm just gonna remove the skin from that garlic. Doesn't matter if we smash them too much with the back of our knife because I'm gonna put them through a garlic crusher. But you can finely slice them with your knife if you don't have one. I just think this texture works a little bit better in the sauce. And then I like a little heat in this sauce, so I'm gonna add 2 red chilies. One of my pregnancy cravings, I think I've mentioned this before, has been chili. So I am going a little harder on the chili than I usually would at the moment. And then I'm just going to finely dice that up. And that's all our prep work done, and now we're just gonna fry it up over on the stove. So we do need a lot of olive oil for this sauce, about 6 tablespoons, and I'm using a really nice extra virgin olive oil. So that's 1, 2. And I'm gonna bring the olive oil to heat and then turn the heat right down just so that garlic and chili doesn't burn. But we can put that in before the oil's hot. Once that's got a slight sizzle to it, I'm gonna add in the capers, about 1/2 tablespoon or as many as you like. And then I'm gonna turn the heat all the way down to low. And we're gonna fry this for about 3 to 4 minutes. Just until that garlic is slightly cooked. And then I'm gonna show you a little trick to how my mother makes this sauce, which is what makes it extra special. All right, so I've been cooking that for about 2 to 3 minutes just to cook through that garlic without burning or browning it. Now I'm just gonna give it a little season of salt. And here comes the Dane's kitchen family secret, which is to add in about 1/2 cup of water. And then we're just going to leave that simmer and cook it until all of that water has been absorbed by the garlic and the chili and the capers, because what that is going to do is allow that garlic to have a little room to breathe, and it's gonna get really soft and really sweet, and it's gonna have this beautiful flavor and texture to it. You'll see that that water has all been absorbed, and you can actually just listen to it because that's the sauce's way of telling us that all that water is gone, because you can hear that olive oil sizzle now. And that's perfect. I'm just gonna take that off the stove and set it aside until we're ready to serve it on our steak. Now that it's time to cook the steak, let's keep going through those steak rules. So number 3, I think we're up to, maybe number 4, is you wanna cook it in a cast iron heavy pan that's piping, piping hot. And I'm using a neutral oil today, which is very blasphemy for Dane's kitchen cooking. It's not olive oil, but it is important to have a high smoke point oil when cooking your steak because we're gonna do it really, really hot. So put about 1 tablespoon in there. And we're just gonna wait till that's piping hot. And while we're waiting, I have prepared my aromatics that I'm gonna cook the steak in, which is some thyme, rosemary, some peeled garlic cloves, and I've got a lot of butter that we're gonna baste it in. I'll talk you through that when we're cooking it. So we're gonna put the steak in and we're gonna lay it down away from us just so that oil doesn't splatter up. And I'm gonna cook that for 2 minutes and 10 seconds. It does vary how long you cook a steak for depending on its size and thickness, but the general rule of thumb is that you want your steak to be 130 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit internally for medium rare. And there is no other way to cook a steak than medium rare. You cannot argue me on that. And now another rule, which I think we're up to rule number 5 or 6, is that we do not touch it. We want it to get that beautiful crust, and to do that, you've just got to leave it sitting in that pan.
All right, let's flip. Oh, and look at that beautiful crust. All right, so we're going to cook that for a minute, and then when we've got another minute left of cooking, I'm going to add all those aromatics and butter in just to give it a beautiful butter bubble bath and to baste it in, and that's going to beautifully flavor your steak. So we're going to add some butter in. Just be careful. There might be a bit of splashback. Some thyme and rosemary. Oh, there was a bit of water on that herb. Make sure yours don't have water on them when you put them into hot oil. And then some garlic. And now we're going to baste it. So lean the pan towards you. And just throw that all on there. I like to get the herbs and garlic to sit on there. So just keep basting that. Put some of the garlic on top. Okay, now we're going to take it off. We have two beautiful steaks. This one I'm gonna put my garlic and olive oil sauce onto, and this has my garlic herb butter that's already melting away on it. I wanted to put it on when it was hot straight off the pan because that's just gonna melt all over it and just infuse it with that gorgeous buttery, garlicky flavor. So I've been letting my steaks rest for around 5 to 10 minutes, because what that does when we rest a steak is it allows those juices to just reabsorb and redistribute themselves throughout the steak, and it's not going to bleed when we cut into it. It's really, really important that you let your steaks rest. That is a non-negotiable rule. So this one's had a little longer and I'm going to cut into it now. Oh, that's cooked beautifully. And that is cooked to perfection. That's a beautiful medium rare juicy steak. I'm gonna plate number one steak up. Put it on our board there. And this one was for the garlic and olive oil sauce, which I've got sitting here, which is just looking beautiful. And I'm actually not going to scoop up a lot of the olive oil. I only wanna get a little bit of that. What I'm mainly after is those garlic, caper, and chili pieces. Yum. Now we're gonna cut into steak number two that's got that beautiful roasted garlic herb butter melting all over it. You can just like spread it out as well. Oh, that one is cooked perfectly as well. Now I'm gonna plate that one up as well. And then this wouldn't be the ultimate steak meal without some chips. And these are my triple cooked chips that I have made in my fish and chip video. So if you wanna see a more detailed process on how to make the perfect chips to go with your perfect steak, then check that out. If you liked this video, please follow, like, and subscribe. And if you made this recipe at home, please let me know in the comments. I love nothing more than hearing about you cooking my recipes at home. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you next time. All right, I am gonna dig into, it's hard to choose, but I think I'm gonna go the garlic one. Yum.